When Steve Jobs died in 2011, his admirers paid tribute around the world. This kind of turnout was usually reserved for rock stars, not a CEO. Yet this age arguably belongs to those who build the future. According to the Forbes list of the richest people in the world in 2021, 7 out of the top 10 made their fortune in engineering. Amazon's Jeff Bezos, Tesla and SpaceX's Elon Musk, Microsoft's Bill Gates, Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg, Oracle's Larry Ellison, Google's Larry Page, and Sergey Brin. It's hard to think of an engineer from the 70s who was super well known, yet today's engineers are household names, whether we love him or love to hate him. Musk even guest hosted Saturday Night Live, which is usually reserved for famous actors and artists. He's a new kind of celebrity, with such a huge Twitter following that he's a walking advertisement for Tesla. In fact, Tesla doesn't spend money on advertising, which I talked about in another video. So, how did engineers become cool? They used to be known for building public infrastructure, like bridges and dams. Necessary for any functioning society, but not something that would normally attract crowds. Then, Jobs came along. He didn't have a technical background, but he had his hands in everything at Apple, including engineering. The world changed when he put the internet in everyone's pocket with the introduction of the iPhone in 2007. The late Apple CEO built a following by creating personal inventions that excited people. Since then, engineers have continued to create products that are in your personal space, be it a smartwatch or social media, which has in turn made them famous. And the appetite for such products is only growing. Engineers are expected to experience a 3% job growth in a decade, which is on par with average, while the demand for software developers is predicted to soar 22%. They're the ones responsible for writing and designing code to develop apps. In other words, creating the products we crave. An increasing number of people are choosing the profession. In India, 30% of students pursued a degree in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, which produced almost 2.7 million graduates in 2018. Where I live, in Canada, enrollment in math, computer, and information sciences has increased 47%, comparing a recent academic year to an earlier one. In a previous video, I mentioned that engineering degrees are now more common than MBA degrees amongst the world's top-performing CEOs, which makes sense given some of the biggest companies are tech giants. There's also the belief that engineers rise to the top because they're good problem solvers. Google's former chief financial officer, Patrick Pichette, once pointed out that Google is really an engineering company with all these computer scientists that see the world as a completely broken place. Engineers try to solve the most pressing issues of the day using technology. Musk is a self-taught engineer who wants to reduce pollution with his electric vehicles and is confident the century-long dominance of the internal combustion engine, otherwise known as ICE, is coming to a close.
Well, I don't think there will be an ICE industry long-term. There's still like some steam engines made somewhere, but like they're just basically sort of quirky collector's items. I mean, that will be the future of the internal combustion engine car.
At the same time, people like him have warned of a dark side to technology. He believes super intelligent machines could pose a threat to humanity and has called for government oversight of artificial intelligence, fearing AI will surpass humans in intelligence in the way we outsmart cats. Smart machines are expected to eliminate many human jobs. FedEx has now teamed up with a robotics company to test out autonomous delivery vehicles. Amazon runs cashierless grocery stores and wants to deliver packages by drone in under 30 minutes. The World Economic Forum says the rise of automation will result in a loss of 85 million jobs by 2025, yet in the same breath adds 97 million new jobs will be created, such as AI and machine learning specialists and data analysts. There's also the argument that future technology will redefine the meaning of the traditional work week. More than 100 years ago, people worked 70 hours a week, on average. With the Industrial Revolution and labor laws, it's now down to about 35 hours. The former head of British Petroleum, Lord John Brown, remarked, "Why do we then define work as a 35-hour week? Why can't it be 17 and a half?" Behind these forces of societal change are engineers who dream big. Bezos' space venture, Blue Origin, has dreamt up space colonies straight out of 70s science fiction, though the plan hasn't won over a fellow billionaire who has a different vision of humanity in space. Musk's SpaceX expects Mars to be colonized by a constant flow of humans traveling aboard starships. So long as we have a desire for new adventures and new things, engineers will continue to build the future and enjoy all the attention that comes along with it. At the core of an engineer is exceptional skill and ability. If you'd like to brush up on your math or computer science skills, or you simply want to learn more about how our world works, my sponsor Brilliant can help, and it's free to sign up. Brilliant is a website and app built off the principle of learning while doing. You simply pick a course and jump right in. One of my favorites is the logic courses. If you're feeling stuck on a problem, you can read the explanations to find out more. Brilliant has something for everybody. Besides the math, science, and computer science courses, you can even dive into cutting-edge topics like cryptocurrency. If you'd like to join me and a community of 8 million learners and educators, click the link in my description or visit brilliant.org/newsthink. The first 200 people to use my link will get 20% off the premium subscription, which gives you unlimited access to all the courses. For Newsthink, I'm Cindy Pom.